Ino. I-R-U-M. We was,
What are you doing, Bullwinkle?
I'm learning to conjugate.
The word is conjugate.
That's right, Rock.
What for?
What'd I say it for?
No, why are you learning to conjugate?
Because conjugalation is very important in the communication of all lively people.
That's very true, Bullwinkle.
For instance, let me conjugate the next fantasy fountain show.
You can do that?
Sure.
How?
By using the verbiage to be.
If to be or not to be, I'd rather not to be.
Why is this, Boris?
Because if not to be, I would not have to be here listening to Moose pretend to be brilliant.
Who's brillianting? I'm conjugating.
Whatever that is, you are much more than that.
What's he mean by that, Rogue?
It's not important, Bullwinkle. Now tell me how you conjugate the next fantasy fountain show.
Oh, yeah. Well, for instance, the verbiage to be jeebies.
To be jeebies? An example.
Yeah. I be, you be, he be.
I don't know, Bullwinkle. I thought it was more like I am, you are, we will be.
No. I be, you be, he be.
I be, you be, he be.
That's it, Rock. I be jeebies, you be jeebies, he be jeebies.
He be jeebies.
You got it, Rock.
I did. What'd I get?
The he be jeebies conjugation.
Oh, boy. Let's hope it's not contagious.
I got the he be jeebies.
Not only that, you got the title of our next fantasy fountain show.
I did?
Yeah.
What is it?
The he be jeebies.
I hope I don't get the he be jeebies.
Why not, darling?
It is not only sounding dangerous, it sounds confusing.
Hey, Rock, you know anything about the Kiss Polka?
Like what, Bullwinkle?
You know the polka's a dance, right?
Yeah.
And that you gotta move a lot while you poke around.
Yeah.
Sometimes jumping from side to side.
Yeah.
Sometimes jumping up and down.
Yeah.
How could you even get close to kissing at a time like that?
Yeah.
You might miss your mark.
Yeah.
And get hurt.
Yeah.
Rock?
Yeah.
You all right?
Yeah.
I mean, you feeling okie dokie?
Yeah.
You're still my friend and everything?
Yeah.
Well, you sound like a broken record.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Squirrel just broke record for more yas than any routine in Hollywood.
Yeah, too bad he didn't break record over Moose's head.
Yeah?
Yeah!
Hey, Rock, it's catching.
Yeah!
Maybe we better just get on to the next water show.
Yeah!
Hey, folks, here's the Kiss Polka.
Yeah!
Yeah.
How about some pizza, Bullwinkle?
Yeah.
How about not saying yeah anymore, Bullwinkle?
Yeah.
It's showtime again. And we direct your attention to our center stage where we present that star of stage, screen, TV, and the Thanksgiving Day Parade, Bullwinkle!
Hi to you lovers of fine food and fabulous fun!
Bullwinkle, you a star of the Thanksgiving Day Parade?
Yeah, in New York City. Most years they got a great big balloon shaped just like me that floats above the parade.
You ever see that parade, Boris?
Sure. I couldn't tell the balloon from the real Bullwinkle.
Why, darling?
Because they're both full of hot air.
Darling, don't you ever say anything nice about anybody?
I did once. I said to my old grandmama, "Gee, Willikers, babushka, I sure do love you."
What happened?
She washed my mouth out with soap.
Oh, how'd that make you feel?
Absolutely lousy.
So sorry.
Oh, not me. I love to feel lousy.
T-Rock, how do you feel today?
I guess I shouldn't say, with my hands.
Thank you, Rock. That's not exactly what I meant.
I know, Bullwinkle. I just couldn't resist. Actually, I feel pretty good.
Compared to what?
Oh, Bullwinkle.
Sorry, I couldn't resist either.
You know, if Moose and Squirrel stop resisting, maybe we can get on with this show.
Good idea, Boris. Hey, Rock, did Did you ever meet anybody who made you feel like dancing?
Gee, I don't know.
Somebody who makes you feel so good that you just can't sit still?
You talking about yourself, Bullwinkle?
That's great, Rock. You feel the same way I do.
How's that, Bullwinkle?
I make you feel like dancing, you make me feel like dancing.
Bullwinkle, you make me feel like dancing is the name of the next water show.
Yeah, me too.
You know, once was someone who made me to feel like dancing, Natasha.
Oh, Boris, someone make you feel like dancing, really?
You bet.
Oh, thank you, darling. That is so nice of you.
Sorry, Honeybun, was not you.
No?
No, was fearless instructor in bump throwing class at spy school.
Yes?
Yes.
How did this happen?
He was very, very nearsighted.
Yes, go on.
He thought my shoelace was fused to bump.
He didn't.
He did. He lighted my foot.
And?
I got the hot foot, and boy, did I feel like dancing.
Just snap your fingers and I'm walking.
Let us boogie, boogie, boogie.
We already did, Bullwinkle.
We did?
Yeah, we just heard bandstand boogie.
Well, I'm on the bandstand and I want to boogie some more.
You'll have to wait, Bullwinkle.
For what?
The next show.
But why?
Because it's kind of hard to boogie without music.
Yeah, so?
So there's no more music until the next show.
I knew that.
Well then,
let's boogie.
Boogie where?
I'm glad you asked. Let us boogie down to Underdog's mighty metropolis and make us some music with those games.
You win.
But Rock, we haven't even played yet. You happy frolickers of fine food and fun happiness?
You're in a pretty good mood, Bullwinkle. How come?
Well, it's time for some classy music again on our Fantasy Fountain Show.
But Bullwinkle, the Fantasy Fountain Show is always classy.
Yeah, but Rock, this time we're talking real classy.
How much is real classy?
Well, I can tell by the names of the composers.
Really?
You bet. There's a list of composers who write symphonies, and they're really supposed to be the classy of the class guys.
It's symphonies, Bullwinkle. And just what are some of these names?
Oh, no, let's see. There's Moose Art. There's Paganini. Rock's Man is Off. Rimsky's Kortzets Off. And Johann's The Batch in the Box.
Sounds like a who's who in the spy world.
Oh, yes, they do have a ring to them, don't they?
Yes, a bad ring at that.
And last but not least, the very famous classy composer of music all over the world, and the person who actually composed the music for our next water show. What was that?
A ta-da chord.
Oh.
Go on, Bullwinkle. Who's the composer?
None other than Peter Itchy Tchaikovsky.
That's Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky.
That's what I said. And he wrote the next three tunes to the Fantasy Fountain Show.
What's the first one, Bullwinkle?
It is from the Nutcracker, and he is really sweet.
That's the Nutcracker sweet, Bullwinkle.
At the Waldorf Astoria?
Bullwinkle.
What, Rock?
What's the name of the tune?
Hum a few bars, and I'll tell you.
Moose, hum a few bars, and no telling what could happen.
Bullwinkle, what's the name of the first piece of music for the water show?
I thought I told you already.
Not exactly.
Oh, well, sorry. It's a fairy nice number.
Yeah?
Fairy nice. Fairy nice, get it?
I don't want it, and you can have it.
Terrific, Bullwinkle. Now, what is the number? Will you please introduce the music?
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen of all ages and with ears for listening, Bullwinkle's Food and Fun proudly presents The Dance of the Sugar with the Plumber and the Fairy from the Nutcracker, who, by the way, is a really sweet man, composed by Mr. Peter Itchy Shy Coughseat.
That's The Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairy from the Nutcracker Suite by Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky.
I knew you'd get it, Rock. Well, on with the show.
Thank goodness already.
Thank you.
old Pete Itchy sure knew how to write that music, didn't he, Rock?
He sure did.
I wonder if it's hard to get all them folks playing together with their instruments and stuff.
Probably not if that's what you're used to doing. People who play music really like to do it, Bullwinkle.
Hey, we got people like that right here, Rock.
Musicians?
Well, maybe so. But there's people always playing together and stuff at Underdog's Mighty Metropolis. I guess they just like to do what they're doing too, huh, Rock?
Something like that, Bullwinkle.
Yeah. Heidi, Rock! Rock?
What, Bullwinkle?
I noticed earlier you was limping. Something wrong?
Yeah, Bullwinkle. Remember yesterday you stepped on my toe?
Well, sure, Rock, but I moved my foot right away.
Yeah, Bullwinkle, to my other toe.
Sorry.
That's getting the moose on the other foot.
Well, Rocky, you know what I always say.
What's that?
Better to be on somebody's foot than under toe.
How about underfoot? That's something moose should know a great deal about.
Bullwinkle, I've never heard you say that before.
That's because I just made it up.
Yes, you have a lot to make up for, Moose.
What's all this carrying on about?
Hey, that's a great idea, Natasha. Let us carry on with the show. Boy, that was a great song. Do you know what it was called?
Yeah, Give Me the Night.
Oh, must be a tough one to remember.
No, Oh, Bullwinkle, I remember. I just told you, give me the knife.
Well, anything you want, little pal, but it sure must be a long title.
No, I mean, give me the knife is the title of the song.
Oh, well, maybe I don't like it so much anymore.
Why not?
Well, I think that's awful selfish of him. If we gave him the whole night, then what would we have? We'd be like them Eskimos. 6 months without the night. We'd be falling asleep on the job all the time.
Shouldn't hurt your humor any, Moose.
Calm down, Bullwinkle. I think you've misunderstood.
Well, I would like to give that there feller a piece of my mind.
I don't think you can afford it, Moose.
What's the next song, Rock? Maybe that'll soothe me down a little.
Heart and soul.
Golly, he wants more than the last guy.
Let's just get on with the music.
Figured a way to make those songs better.
You mean less offensive.
What's football got to do with it?
Oh, never mind. Just go on.
He usually does.
Anyways, I thought they might just change things a little so they weren't asking so much. Like, how about the Loan Me the Night or Heart and Pocketbook?
Sounds like a bank's motto.
Or how about the Lease Me the Twilight or Heart and Necktie? I know I got some neckties I wouldn't mind giving to a good cause.
Why don't you work on it for a while, okay, Bullwinkle?
Okay, little feller. Goodbye, everybody. Stick around for our next show.